Hey guys, Eagle here. So today I'm going to talk to you about Hot Wheels wheel types. According to the Hot Wheels Wikipedia website, there are over 70 wheel types that Hot Wheels uses, and today I'm only going to talk to you about 15 of those wheel types. This video is pretty much aimed at new collectors or collectors who maybe just wanted to know more about the subject. So without further ado, we'll get into it. So first up, I've got the 5-spoke or 5SP wheel. It's a stock-looking wheel, and it's used on a variety of different castings. I've just got the Volkswagen Caddy here to demonstrate what the wheel looks like on a casting. The next wheel type I've got is the 10-spoke, and its code is 10SP. It's a performance-looking, predominantly Japanese-used wheel type. So it looks really good on the Subaru WRX. Next up is the Toyota off-road truck using Blore tires. It's a newly introduced type of wheel, actually, and stands for beadlock off-road wheel. So just to repeat that, it's beadlock off-road wheel. So the code is Blore. So it's just an acronym. Pretty cool wheels, actually. I really do like these wheels, and they do suit off-road vehicles. The next wheel type is the FTE2. So FTE stands for Faster Than Ever, and this is the second version of those Faster Than Ever wheels. I'll talk to you a little bit more about the first version later on in the episode. So basically, when you're talking about FTE2 or FTE wheels, that's basically just referring to Hot Wheels axle. They have nickel-plated axles which make the car roll faster because there's less friction between the axle and the pegs and the wheel that are on the base. And it's worth mentioning also that in the States, I actually heard these wheel types called Trap 5 or Trapezium 5s. So I did a little bit of research on it. And these FTE2 wheels, generally, if they're used with the nickel-plated axle, making them go faster, they are in a bronze color. And when they're not in a bronze color, they are Trap 5 wheels, meaning they do not have the nickel-plated axle, but they still sport the same design. So it is just worth mentioning that. So this is the 11 Corvette Grand Sport, and that's sporting Trap 5 wheels. Next up, we've got the J5, which stands for Japanese 5-spoke. Awesome looking wheel on this casting. It's on the Nissan Skyline GTR R32. They really do suit these Japanese vehicles. Next up is the LW lace wheel, or it's also known as the wire spoke, so WSP is the code. So these are generally used on older European vehicles, like the Aston Martin, cars like that. So it's a nice looking wheel. It does suit this Porsche, in my opinion. It looks really good. Next up, we've got the MC5, Muscle Car 5-spoke. I've got the Dodge Challenger concept here to just show you what it looks like on here. It's an awesome wheel type and is used on a variety of castings. The Hakkasuka Skyline, even though it's a Muscle Car 5-spoke, had these wheels. So it's not just for muscle cars, it's used on all sorts of other cars too, but it does look really nice on this Dodge. Alright, next up we've got the Moon Disc. So this is a real rider only, the Moon Discs. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that is the case, that the Moon Discs are only used on real riders. You either sort of love it or you hate it, these Moon Discs, I've found when you talk to people about it. And on this particular casting, I believe it does suit it. It does look quite cool. Purely because they've gone for the silver pinstriping and things like that. But it is a less common wheel type. You don't often see it too much. Alright, next up I've got the OH5 on the Nissan Skyline R32. So OH stands for open hole. So you can see there, if the camera is strong enough to show you guys, the open hole is basically referring to where the axle's coming through here. It is quite a larger gap. And also there are holes between the spokes, so you can see through to the chrome base. So those are used on a huge amount of cars. They're, you know, it's not just Japanese castings. They're used on fantasy models, as well as American castings and European castings, just wherever suits. So that's the OH5. Next up, I've got my favorite, which is the PR5. PR5 stands for Phil Ryleman 5 spoke. And if you guys don't know, Phil Ryleman is a Hot Wheels designer. And so he designed these wheels, and they've been in use for quite a while now. They look really nice. They're really nice looking wheel type. Sweet. So that was a PR5. And then next up, I'm just going to get into my script here, which I've got. So this one here is the Real Rider 5 spoke, and its code is RR5SP. So I've got the 2016 A case, Super Treasure Hunt, Tesla Roadster here to show you. So you can see the 5 spoke there. It is a really nice wheel type. I've drilled a few of these cars, and not these Teslas, but some other cars from Pop Culture series, just to get the wheels for customs, because they do look really nice on those cars. Sweet, so that was the RR5SP. Next up, I've got the Real Rider Exotic wheels. So this is the 2016 CK Super, the 90 Acura NSX, and they are really nice wheels. The code for these are RREX, so Real Rider Exotic. And these wheels, they just look like they've just come straight out of a Ferrari factory or something. They look really cool. So it's that 5-spoke design. They look really, really nice. On this Acura, at least they do. And next up, we've got the Retro Slot Wheel. This was introduced in the 2013 Hot Wheels Cool Classics lineup. So its code is RSW, Retro Slot Wheels. I've got the 85 Honda CRX here, which is the wheels are sitting on. The car's sitting on. And personally, I'm not a huge fan of the wheel myself, but it does suit this Honda. But some of the other castings they brought out in the Cool Classics with these wheels, I just thought were horrible. I just didn't like them too much. So we're almost there, guys. This is the ultra hot BMW M1. So it's using, well, it's on ultra hot wheels. Just a bit of history for you guys. It was originally used on the ultra hot series in the mid 80s. But it was used on other vehicles up until 1995. And then they reintroduced it in the Hot Ones series, which is the one I've got here. You can see in the top corner, it says the Hot Ones. And I'm sure most of you guys who have been collecting for a while would have recognized this series. It's a very unique wheel type, and they do look really good on the older vehicles. Sweet. And so the last wheel type I've got to show you guys today is the Y5. Not to be confused with Wi-Fi, but it's the Y5 wheels. I've got the Volkswagen Golf here to show you guys how it looks. As you can see, the wheel spokes do resemble a Y shape. If I tilt it, you can see the Y shape. But yeah, it's used on a variety of vehicles. It's not just a European specific or a Japanese specific casting. But yeah, so thanks for watching, guys. And before I end the video, I wanted to leave you with a quick quiz. So I'll create 6 slides, 5 of which will contain questions and the final one will contain the answers. They're all based off of the wheel types. So good luck with that, guys. Leave a comment if you want to, and thanks for watching.